cool. Hey there, it's Devin with Make Anything, and today we've got a video that should be pretty quick, but it's also really exciting because we're talking about smoothing 3D prints. When you're working with FDM 3D printers, like I tend to do on this channel, one of the inherent side effects of the process of FDM printing is that your prints are gonna have layer lines. Regardless of how expensive your printer is or how small you make your layer height, you can almost always see those layer lines. Usually, I'm pretty okay with that. I actually think layer lines can be kind of cool because they're evidence of the process of 3D printing, which is also really cool. But other times, you wanna smooth out your part. You want it to be nice and shiny and look great, and that's what we're gonna talk about. If you've spent some time learning about 3D printing, you may have heard of some different techniques for smoothing out 3D prints. The most popular is probably ABS smoothing, and I've already done a video about that. That's not what we're talking about today, but ABS smoothing is basically where you take an ABS plastic print, immerse it in a cloud of acetone vapors, and that will chemically smooth out the part. Now, acetone smoothing is pretty cool and it's relatively easy to do, but what I don't like about it is the fact that you have to print with ABS, which releases fumes while printing, and you'll often have to print in an enclosed chamber or suffer warping or other nasty side effects. So I prefer not to print with ABS, and that's why I don't use acetone smoothing too often. Another option is to use special filaments like this PolySmooth filament from PolyMaker and their Polysure machine, as shown in my Mini Monstera video. And that's nice, but it's a process of its own, and once again, you're stuck using a specific filament. Yet another option is to use an epoxy coating like this XTC 3D. I used it in my rock climbing hangboard video, and as you'll see there, epoxy is kind of annoying to work with, so I am not too much of a fan of this, even though it can work really well for certain uses. But another thing about that is you're adding a material on top of the printed part, so your tolerances are gonna get all messed up, and you're not gonna be able to recycle this or anything, so that's kind of annoying. So there's tons of ways to smooth 3D prints that we've known about for a long time, but the one I'm talking about today makes me particularly excited because we're gonna smooth PLA. PLA is my favorite material because it's easily accessible, it's low cost, it's easy to print with, it's biodegradable, everyone loves PLA, so smoothing it is something that a lot of people have wanted to do. I've read about ways to smooth PLA using harsh chemicals like methyl ethyl ketone and other crazy chemical names, but I've been kind of scared off from that because I've heard of flammability issues and just health hazards, so I never really tried that out. But recently I got sent this really cool product called 3D Gloop by a little startup company. And this 3D Gloop stuff is interesting. It comes in liquid form, it comes as a kind of gel in a syringe, and they're also working on a spray-on version. But this stuff is marketed as
the best 3D printing adhesive in the known universe.
And while I've only used this stuff for maybe a week so far, I'm really liking it. There are two versions of this, one for PLA and one for ABS. They're both meant to be used for bed adhesion as well as to glue parts together, but what I really liked was the idea that you could smooth prints with this stuff. I've got some PLA parts I want to smooth. Let's try it out. First off, I will mention that like other existing methods of PLA smoothing, 3D Gloop does have some health hazards and it does need to be treated with care. So for this experiment, I will be wearing a respirator, safety goggles, and some nitrile gloves. The creators have said that in small concentrations, this stuff is pretty harmless, but since I'm gonna be coating entire prints with 3D Gloop, I will be wearing my respirator, just to be sure. I decided to start with a small experiment by coating this low poly Squirtle that was printed using the Palette Plus by Mosaic. Let's go ahead and open up this Gloop. You can see there is a brush connected to the lid, and the consistency of the Gloop itself is pretty thin and liquidy. Let's just dip this brush and start coating this model. Right off the bat, I noticed that this stuff starts acting pretty immediately. So as soon as you start brushing on there, the PLA is gonna start smoothing out and also getting a little bit gummy. So you really wanna make sure to do very thin coats. Here's the model after just one thin coat. And as you can see, it's already worked pretty well. The layer lines are nearly invisible in a lot of areas. On the back here, I went a little bit too heavy and it started getting really gummy and messy, so you definitely don't want to just slop this on when you're trying to smooth your model. And I'm sure that once the spray version of 3D Gloop is released, that will be the ideal method of application for this process. I can tell that it might take a bit of practice and getting used to get really clean, smooth prints, but I'm already feeling pretty good about this, so I'm gonna go ahead and move on to something a little more extreme. Here we have a model of a cat skull that I printed out for my girlfriend using Filamentum's Vertigo Galaxy, and I already did a bit of sanding before starting this project, so that should help out a bit, but there are also areas on the bottom that still have all the layer lines, so it should still be a good test. I went ahead and started coating on, trying to keep the layers a bit thinner this time, and once again, right off the bat, you can see the model start to smooth as I'm brushing this on. Once it gets to that point, I found it's good to stop and wait a couple minutes before applying another thin coat until you're happy with how smooth it is. I think I ended up doing about 3 thin coats over the entire model before it got to a smoothness that I was happy with. And while it was very smooth, I did notice that this dark black filament got a little bit cloudy. To deal with that, we did a little bit of extra polishing using Brasso metal polish and a paper towel, and that was really effective in bringing back some of that dark color of this print. And as you can see, it also really started to shine. At this point, I was pretty impressed and very happy with how the model was looking, but just to see how far we could push it, we decided to do one more step. And that was to bring it outside, put it on top of a few toothpicks, and go over the entire model with some Rustoleum Clear Gloss Finish. You can find this stuff at just about any hardware store, and I just gave it one thick coat and let it dry overnight. Here it is after that treatment, and now it's just unbelievably shiny, and at the right angle, it really catches the gold glitter in this Vertigo Galaxy filament. It really got taken beyond my expectations at this point, and I think you'll agree that it's a stunning print. Just look at that golden shimmer and shine. It is so cool. So there you have it, guys, smoothed PLA prints. I know I did end up doing a bit of extra post-processing, but I kind of think it's worth it because it came out looking so great, and I'm really excited that this is possible with PLA. I definitely want to play around with this stuff a lot more, but I was just so excited about how well it worked that I had to share it with you guys as soon as I could. So there it is, it's 3D Gloop. I'll put information about it in the description. Let me know in the comments what you guys think about this stuff. Is it cool? Is it worth the work? Is it worth the price? Is there a better way to smooth PLA prints, or should we not smooth PLA prints? Anyways, that's it for today. I'm Devin. This is Make Anything. Don't forget to stay inspired.